here we are with Mike Morton, the champion of the 2012 Badwater Ultra Marathon. Congratulations.
Yeah.
You're welcome. Yeah. Woo! May hang this medal around your neck. There's your medal. Here is your race ready t-shirt, official finisher. All right, so take that. And then here's the hardware, the holy grail of ultra running, the Badwater belt buckle. So congratulations.
Appreciate it.
Well done.
Thanks, Chris.
22 hours, 52 minutes, 55 seconds. Fantastic. So, Mike, you were doing a lot of ultra running back in the mid to late 90s, including winning the Western States 100 in 1997, and then you kind of went off the radar until recently. So tell us what you've been doing since then.
I just kind of got out of it because of an injury, and then some, you know, work and life took over.
You were in the military?
Yep.
What were you doing?
In the Army, so there's a lot of deployments and stuff, and it was just running was no longer the priority.
Mm-hmm.
So. But I had an opportunity now to get back into it.
And so how long have you been competing again since you came back?
I started focusing in like February 2010, and then I didn't run until September of that year training. So it's about September 2010.
Yeah, so about a little over 2 years.
Yeah.
Wow, so you've had quite a comeback. And when did you decide you wanted to attempt Badwater?
I've always wanted. I mean, that went back all the way to after winning Western States. I wanted to do Badwater next. In fact, Eric and I had been talking about doing it, and then the injury kind of cut it short. So I mean, it's, for 14 years, it's been in the back of my mind.
Wow. All right, so now that you finally got here after 14 years, how did it stack up to what you'd imagined?
A little bit more than what I imagined.
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, it's a very challenging course with the hills and stuff. I mean, I think we got lucky with the weather early, you know, minus the headwind, but.
Yeah, you guys had a lot of headwind there heading up Town Pass and down into the Panamint Valley. Yeah. So you were in the lead basically from the beginning until about the summit of Town Pass, and then Oswaldo Lopez, who was our champion from last year, passed you.
Yeah.
And then I understand you passed him back on the downhill into the Panamint Valley.
Yeah.
And
yeah.
Then you've been in the lead since then, right?
Yep.
So was that pretty much your plan, to try to hold the lead the whole way if you can?
Oh yeah, if I could. I was hoping to kind of take off. I mean, that's kind of, I think Eric taught me that early on. Just try to get as much mileage under your belt as you can and
right.
Put some money in the bank, see what you can do. But I was actually surprised when I was really hurting going up that climb. I underestimated it and haven't had chance to train for stuff like that in Florida.
Right, yeah, the terrain's just a little bit different in Florida than here.
Yeah.
And the weather.
Yeah, a little bit.
So, you know, you must have had some kind of problems and setbacks. It couldn't have been absolutely perfect 100% of the time. So what were some of the things that happened out there for you?
Well, that was it, and then...
You mean getting past?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
And then,
so you weren't happy about having Oswaldo go by you right at the top of Town Pass?
No, and then... a little bit of panic ensued, and then Eric jumped in and kind of talked me, hey, calm down, you know, we're a long ways from the finish, just focus, and kind of regroup, you know, and get back into it when I can.
Yeah. And then did you have any blisters or any kind of problems? Did you get sick, throw up, anything interesting?
Nothing interesting like that. I got a blister and stuff. After dark, I started going to the bathroom a lot. You know, probably stopped and go to the bathroom 5 times. But I just think it was.
So is that all? The only time you stop was nature calls?
Oh yeah.
Otherwise, you kept moving.
Trying to, yeah.
Yeah. Now, what were you eating and drinking?
Gatorade and water mixed. A lot of Coca-Cola.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, coffee.
Any solid food?
Oh yeah, yeah. Pretzels, candy bars.
Well, you're old school.
Yeah.
You know, things have changed since 1997, but you obviously haven't, but except getting even better.
Yeah, if I'm going to run, I'm going to eat candy while I'm doing it.
All right. So, and what did you think of Oswaldo Lopez?
Phenomenal athlete, man. Very Very sportsmanlike.
Yeah, friendly.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. What was it like when he went by? Did you guys say hi to each other?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, I mean, even his crew offered to give me stuff, you know. So I think everybody out here. Even Zach had caught me earlier before Furnace Creek.
Mm-hmm. You
know, another phenomenal guy.
Yep, our champion from a couple years ago.
Good guys.
So you've been mentioning Eric, and that's Eric Clifton, the 1999 Badwater champion who's been on your crew. So why don't we bring Eric and the rest of your crew on up here for some pictures and some words from them. So Eric and crew, come on up. So when you were getting sleepy, that's when Eric put those tights on, right?
Yeah.
So Eric, stand on that side since you're taller.
Well, he can't be in the middle.
No.
Yep. There you go.
Ah, oh, you're screwed.
So congratulations to all of you.
Thank you.
Yeah, well done.
Yay. He made it hard on us. Made it hard and easy. We got a day to spare, but he worked the crap out of us for that day.
All right.
Yeah, couldn't have done it without him, for sure.
So Eric's been here before. How about the rest of you?
I crewed Eric.
And crewed Eric.
And you crewed Eric. All right.
First
fantastic.
Time.
Yeah. Top-notch crew right here.
Yep.
Congratulations.
Tim's been third at OD.
Old Dominion.
Yeah. Old Dominion.
Well done. Well, and what kind of challenges did the crew have taking care of Mike?
Staying ahead of him. Yeah. It was difficult.
It was.
Beating him to the next point, yeah, to pick him up.
Yeah.
Good stuff.
Did it give you any weird surprises, any weird cravings in the middle of the night?
No, not really.
He was easy.
Yeah.
He was very low maintenance.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Tell that to my wife.
At races, he's very low maintenance.
Oh, yeah. Camp Patriot. It's an organization that helps disabled veterans, takes them on like mountaineering trips and stuff. So
you're supporting them?
Yeah.
That's fantastic.
Yeah. Good charity. And obviously my wife, Julie, and my daughter, Bailey.
Now, we have to ask, I mean, you came in about 2 minutes behind the men's course record set in 2007 by Valmer Nunez from Brazil, and he said he wouldn't come back and race again unless somebody broke his record. He's been out here crewing a few times, so, you know, obviously that, I'm assuming that was a goal as you were coming in, it looked close, so tell us how you feel not quite making that.
I mean, obviously that would be great. It is what it is. I gave it what I had. That's what came out. So.
You didn't leave anything on the course, right?
No.
No. So how do you feel right now about coming back?
We'll see. We'll give it a day or two.
All right. Well, you know, tomorrow is the, you know, the pizza party and the video, and so, you know, you can let us know then.
All right.
Any questions from anybody else?
How about the heat? Did the heat bother you at all?
No, I think we got fortunate, you know, and these guys had the hat with the ice in it. You know, all the time. And then I think that tailwind and then eventually the cross and headwind, I mean, kept the air moving by.
That and running quickly.
Any blowing sand?
No, more keeping the hat on the head. The challenge there.
Yeah, there was some real dust devils out over the sand dunes, but not across the road, which was nice. Any other questions, anybody?
Any plans to complete the other bad 135 races?
Yeah, you're interested in going to Brazil, for example, for the Brazil 135?
I'm open to anything, yeah.
All right.
An Arrowhead, perhaps?
Yeah. What about, have you done any winter races?
No.
Not your
thing? I grew up in Michigan. I'm going to go ahead and pass on that.
Okay.
He has summited in Denali, though.
Yeah.
Oh, fantastic.
It works best towards your success. What's your biggest attribute that makes you run this way this fast?
I guess I'm selfish, and I make running my priority at home. That's an attribute.
No, it is when it comes to coming across the finish line first.
Yeah, not another way of saying dedicated.
What do you think about when you're running?
Everything.
Is there any one theme that you, the mantra? Or
politics, about? Mostly.
Yeah. Election year.
Do you listen to music?
No, I don't.
No music?
No.
Because music is a crutch, isn't it?
It is.
All right. Like, that's my attitude.
It's like food.
Just like wetsuits.
Yeah.
Food, wetsuits, air.
Yeah. It's a crutch.
All at one point did you know you had the race in the bag?
Whew. Well, according to Eric, I had it quite a while ago, but I didn't feel comfortable until I could see down there, you know? I mean, Oswaldo was all those guys are capable of anything, you know. If I faltered, I think I was vulnerable. But luckily, you know, it didn't happen. So
when you were coming up the switchbacks, you guys looked back down the road. Could you see him at all?
I don't think so.
But put your head down and
let's put it this way: everything was so small.
Yeah,
we could see like two cars, but we didn't know if there were any runners with them. So
fantastic.
What's the hardest part of the course for you?
For me, it was Towns Pass.
Yeah, because that's a 17-mile, 5,000-foot ascent, and you had a headwind the whole time. Yeah, so
we were no longer in Florida at that point.